Hello everyone, thanks for joining us again and taking the time to watch our latest video. In the first part, we delve into the concept of role-based access control and claims-based authorization within Microsoft Entra ID and Microsoft Entra External ID for external applications. We highlighted its significance in granting users precise access they need to fulfill their duties within your application. I'm Yoel Orbit, a product manager of Microsoft Identity Product Group. In this video, I will guide you through the setup role-based access control for your applications in Microsoft Entra ID and demonstrate how to integrate role-based access control within your application and web APIs effectively. Let's jump in and start with an application roles demo. Open Microsoft Entra Admin Center at entra.microsoft.com and sign in with your administrator account. As we explained in the first part, application developers define the application roles in Microsoft Entra ID application registration, then administrators or helpdesk can assign these application roles to users. From the menu, select Applications and App Registrations. And then, from the list of applications, select your application. From the menu, select App Roles. And then select Create App Role. Enter a display name for the role. Select Users and Groups option so you can assign users and groups to your application role. For the value, enter a name of the role and a description. Then, select Apply to save the changes. Add a second role, like Online Orders. Good, we are all set. Now you can assign users and groups with application roles. In the overview page, under Manage Applications in the local directory, select the name of your application. This will take you to the enterprise application or the service principal of your application. From the menu, select Users and Groups, and then select Add Users or Groups. Select the user you want to assign the role in this application. In this example, I add my account. Then, select the role you want to assign to the user. And select Assign to complete the process. You can assign more roles to the users. To do so, repeat this step. This time, select the other role. That's it. Now, when a user signs in, the security token will contain the application roles assigned to them. Now let's take a look at the application source code. Authorization in ASP.NET Core is controlled with authorize attribute with its parameters. In the most basic form, applying the authorize attribute to a controller, action, or resource page limits access to that component to unauthenticated users. Using the role parameter, you specify which role the current user must be assigned to access the component. In this example, only users with administrator role can access this controller. Multiple roles can be specified as a comma-separated list. In this example, the salary controller is only accessible by users who are member of the HR manager or the finance role. If you apply multiple authorized attributes, then an accessing user must be a member of all roles specified. This sample code requires that the user must be a member of both power users and control panel user role. Next, let's take a look on security groups. As a reminder, you can use security groups to implement role-based access control for your application, where the membership of the users in specific groups are interpreted or represented as their roles in your application. First, create a security group. In Microsoft Entra Admin Center, go to Identity, Groups, All Groups. Then select New Group. Under Group Type drop-down, select Security. Enter a group name, such as Access to Company Portal. Enter a description. You can add members now or do it later. I will add my account to the security group. Finally, select Create. After the security group has been created, you can copy its object ID. You will need it to configure your application. To emit the user's security groups in a security token, go to Application Registration and select your application. Then select Token Configuration and then select Add Group Claim. Select the security group option. This option will emit the security groups the user is a member of. Keep in mind that the number of security groups emitted in the token is limited. To avoid exceeding the limit on number of groups a security token can emit, consider using groups assigned to the application option. It allows you to restrict the groups emitted in security token to the relevant groups for that application. Please refer to the corresponding documentation for more information. You can select the format for how groups are represented in the ID token, Access token, and SAML token. I prefer using Group ID, therefore, I accept the default selection. Select Add to save the changes. Now, upon the user's sign-in, the issued security token will now include the user's membership in security groups. Next, I will show you how to configure your application and web APIs. The recommended way to implement role-based access control via security groups is by using claims-based authorization. In your application program.cs file, in the add authorization method, register an authorization policy, which defines the requirements for a claims validation. When registering a policy, name it appropriately. For instance, you may call it company portal group. Next, set the policy settings to verify if the group's claim exists within the security token of the current user. In the parameter for allowed values, specify the group ID you copied earlier. Finally, as we have done earlier, add the authorized attribute to your controller, action, or razor page. Then apply the policy using the policy property on the authorized attributes to the one you have registered in the program.cs. In this example, is a company portal group policy.
Another option for role-based access control is using custom claims. In Microsoft Entra ID, claims mapping policy modifies the claims emitting in tokens issued for specific applications, with information from the user attributes, custom user attributes, claim transformation, and custom syndication extension, commonly known as custom claims provider. To configure claims mapping policy for your application, use Microsoft Graph or PowerShell script. In this demo, I will show you how to customize the token via Microsoft Entra Admin Center. You first need to configure your application to support claims mapping. From the menu, select Applications and then App Registrations. From the list of applications, select your application. Then, under Manage, select Manifest. In the Manifest, locate the Accept Map Claims attribute and set its value to True. Then select Save. In the Overview page, under Manage Applications in Local Directory, select the name of your application, which will take you to the service principle of the application. Under Manage, select Single Sign-On. Under Attributes and Claims, select Edit. Select Add New Claim and enter a name to the claim you want to issue, for example, Country. There are several options you can choose from. Attribute allows you to map claims from the user profile or custom syndication extension. Transformation lets you configure claims transformation, like to uppercase or lowercase. Directory schema extension lets you map custom user attributes. Continue with the country. From the source attribute dropdown, choose user.country. And select save. You can add more claims, like loyalty number from a custom syndication extension. Attributes from a custom syndication extension start with custom claims provider dot attribute name. We have released a tutorial video detailing the configuration of custom syndication extension and custom claims provider. After you configure the claims mapping, token returned to that application will include all the claims you specified. Note, claims without values may not be included. Remember, each claim you add to the security token may be utilized for authorizing users and controlling their access to your application. In this example, the application now can check the user's country and loyalty number. Now let's examine the configuration of a web application and a web API. For establishing a role-based access control on any claim in the security token, use claim-based authorization. Similar to the group's claim check, you first need to register a policy and provide it with a unique name. Several options are available for you for a claim check. For the demo, I choose a require assertion method, which utilizes a Boolean function for validation. It first validates whether the loyalty number or loyalty tier claims are included within the security token. Then it verifies that the user has been enrolled in the loyalty program for at least 1 month. And again, in your controller, action, or Razor page, apply the policy using the policy property on the authorized attribute to the one you have registered. In this example, it is a loyalty access policy. Role-based access control is a security mechanism that ensures users possess only the essential permissions required to fulfill their roles within an application. We explore three strategies for this: employing application roles, utilizing security groups, and using custom roles through users' profile attributes and custom authentication extension that fetch data from your own data store. Our demonstration covers the implementation of these methods in .NET Web Application and Web APIs. However, their principle of claims-based authorization extends beyond the .NET ecosystem. They can apply across various platforms and programming languages. The key steps involving configuring your Microsoft Entra ID to admit the appropriate claims, assigning the necessary users' permissions, and verifying the claims value within the security token in your application. Thanks for tuning in, and looking forward to connecting with you again. Goodbye.